Confounds of the Amazon, the real Amazon. So many neat things to see. Botanists would have a field day. Biologists would have a field day. Chemist should have a field day. Astrobiologist, not so much. Whatever that is. Astrobiology. That's a joke. Astrobiology. Assumption that living organisms can make themselves. It's a big assumption. And the assumption is that there's no creator, so they had to have made themselves. Two assumptions. Two faulty assumptions. It's just laughable. They don't know how laughable it is. But I feel for them. I feel for them. Yep. God takes the foolish of this world to put to shame those who call themselves wise and intelligent and knowledgeable. They don't know or understand anything because they've already assumed there's no maker. And before you can understand anything, you have to understand that you have a maker. If you don't understand that, you're not going to understand anything. Not going to understand a thing. That's why they have such a thing as an astrobiologist. That's why they have organizations called SETI. That's why NASA spends their time looking for aliens with our money. Man, it's all right to send probes. Send probes. Find out what's out there. Learn more. Learn all you can. But don't make the assumption that there's life out there that makes itself. It's just an absurd belief. Billions and billions and billions of years aren't enough for that. 20 billion years and you can't randomly sequence a single protein chain, let alone fold them. let alone have it viable so it's going to protect its own information that it randomly programmed by chance. It's laughable. Utter lunacy. A thing that you hear a lot, people will say, well, show me a God. Well, you can't expect to see the maker of everything there is. After all, he's the maker of the programmable elements that are programmed inside of you, inside the fabrication of expanded space and expanded time. It's a fabrication. Time is a fabrication. Distance is a fabrication. When distance expands, time expands. It's all a fabrication. It's all a fabrication. The elements are a fabrication. It takes 17 elements to make a living organism. Not to mention the chemical compounds that are also required as the chemical bonding of those 17 elements. And then there's about 17 more elements that are beneficial to living organisms. Not absolutely necessary, but beneficial. Even things like silicon. Silicon is what we're walking on, what we're standing on. What holds the dust of the earth that you're made out of. That's silicon. That's what you stand on. So that was almost essential, but it's not essential for the living organism itself. It's essential for a planet to stand on. I mean, why not? Between boiling and freezing temperatures, might as well use silicon as a solid for us to stand on. It works great. Plant trees to make use of the carbon in the ground and to take carbon dioxide out of the air. Plant trees. Plant more trees. Take back the deserts that were formed as a result of deforestation in the Middle East, especially. Take back the deserts. Plant trees. I mean, you have everything you need right here. Worried about carbon. Worried about CO2. CO2 is an essential element for living organisms. CO2 is what makes possible plants giving you food and oxygen. I mean, just think about it. You split CO2 and you got oxygen, you got carbon, which is the food that you eat. Food that you eat is carbon molecules. That's what you need to live, to survive. To live and breathe and walk. CO2 is essential. It's an essential molecule. Plants need more of it so they can give you more food and oxygen.